In this example, I will demonstrate how we can use MATLAB for matrix calculations to determine the rates of three reactions we have if the measurements the rates of production of five species. So what I mean by that is if we look at three reactions, molecule A1 reacts with molecule A5 to make A2, A2 reacts with A5 to make A3, A3 reacts with A5 to make A4. Sequential hydrogenation reaction, for example. And what we measure is the rates of each of the species. So A1 is negative because it's being used up. Rate of A5 is also negative because it's been used up. But we're forming A2, A3, and A4, and these are the rates. So what we want to do is take these rates and determine what is the rate of this first reaction, what is the rate of the second reaction, and what's the rate of the third reaction. And so we have more measurements than we're unknowns, and so we have to do a least squares fit to do this, and that'll give us the best fit to the data for these three reactions. And so first what we're going to do is define a stoichiometric matrix. We're going to call that nu, and the idea is this is the stoichiometry of A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5, the stoichiometry in each of these reactions. So if it's a reactant, it's minus 1. If it's a product, it's plus 1. So the first one, that's a 1. 3 and 4 are not involved, and 5 is minus 1. And likewise, if we write for the second reaction, then 5 is a reactant. So this is our matrix. And then we're going to define the matrix of rates as just being these rates that are indicated here. So matrix with these five rates in it. So I've indicated the matrix for the rates of production of the species. Now we're going to determine the rate of the three steps. So this rate is also a matrix. This is a 3x1 matrix. And as shown, for example, in the textbook by Rollins and Eckert, the stoichiometric coefficient times the transpose of the stoichiometric coefficient. Take the inverse of that, multiply by the stoichiometric coefficient, multiply by the matrix for rates of production, and we end up with the least squares fit to determine the rates of the three steps. So we're going to solve this with MATLAB. Here's the MATLAB program. So if we run this in MATLAB, then here's our result. It's rate of the first reaction, rate of the second reaction, rate of the third reaction. So we've taken the production rates and now determined the rates of the three reactions using a least squared fit. Let's look at how we would input this into MATLAB. I have MATLAB open. The first thing I want to do, go to File, New, and open a script. And then I'm going to type in the first two commands are just to clear the workspace and the command window. And then we're going to input the matrix. So I'm calling the matrix new. I use a bracket to indicate the matrix. And then the value is minus 1. I'm going to use a space to separate each of the components of the matrix. And then use a semicolon to separate one line, one row of the matrix. So the next row, 0, in a space, 1, 0, and minus 1. And we can make this a little clearer to see by moving it over like that. Again, put a semicolon and put in the third line, keeping in mind we're putting spaces between each of the terms in the matrix. And then a bracket to indicate the end of the matrix. Now, a semicolon, where this semicolon indicates something different. This indicates I don't want MATLAB to print out the value of the matrix when it's doing the solution. I'm going to do the same thing, define R as a matrix, and this is a 5x1 matrix, and it has the measured production rates. Since I want this to be a 5x1 matrix, this is the first row. Well, I could use return like I did before, but I don't have to, as long as I've used the semicolon to separate it. The third row, and likewise for the other two rows. Again, we're going to in the matrix with a bracket and use a semicolon so that line's not printed out. we want to determine are the rates, and this is a 3x1 matrix. So I'm going to take the inverse of the matrix multiplied by the transpose. So the prime there, the apostrophe indicates transpose. Now I'm going to multiply that by the stoichiometric matrix again. I'm going to multiply it by the matrix R. And I'm finished. So I want to do a couple of things. First, I want to save this. So I do save as, and so I'm going to call it rates of reaction with no spaces. Now I can save it. I go to debug and say run this program. Then it gives me the three rates. If I wanted it to also run and print out these other matrices, that original information that we put in, then I could remove the semicolons and I'll save it again and again tell it to run. So I remove the previous result because of the clear statements. Now here's the matrix. Here's the rates matrix of production of the species. Here's the rates of the three reactions that were determined by a least squares fit.